Hello friends, welcome to Vidyutech. This is Sai Prakash. In this video, I would like to solve important questions regarding SSC JEE Electrical. So, here comes the question friends. We have to find equivalent resistance across the following terminals for this problem. Okay, this is XY terminals, XZ terminals, XU terminals, YU terminals, ZU terminals, AB terminals, AY terminals, BY terminals, BU terminals and BX terminals. Okay. Here comes 3 ohm resistance, 1 ohm resistance, 2 ohm resistance and a short circuit, 5 ohm resistance, 2 ohm resistance, 1 ohm resistance, 4 ohm resistance and 6 ohm resistance for this circuit diagram. Okay, this is X terminal, this is Y terminal, this is Z terminal, this is U terminal, this is terminal A and terminal B. Okay, in the previous video, that is lecture number 4 of important questions and expected questions of SSC JEE Electrical, I solved these 5 problems. In this video, I would like to solve another 5 problems. I told you I want you to do these problems. I hope you all did the problems. And coming to this problem, we have to find equivalent resistance between AB terminals. Okay, this is a tunnel A and tunnel B. So, to take out the confusion, I am taking voltage source over here between A and B terminals, because I am finding the equivalent resistance between A and B. Okay, I am taking 100 volts voltage source. You can take any value friends, no matter. Okay, here comes the current I in this path, because current always flows from positive to negative. Okay, like this current will flow through 1 ohm resistance. After this, here you can see open circuit. So, take out from the circuit. Through 5 ohm resistance, again here is the open circuit. Here you have two paths, path 1 and path 2. Okay, as this is the short circuit, you can take out the 12 ohms from the circuit. Here you can see two paths. This is path with resistance, this is path with lesser resistance. So, always choose low resistance path. So, total current will be flowing through this path. If I take this as I1, if I take this as I2, as total current will be flowing through this path, I1 will be equivalent to I and I2 will be equivalent to 0 amperes. Okay, so current will follow this path and at this, you can take this out from the 4 ohms, current will flow and to the negative terminal of the battery. So it forms a closed path. Friends, I am redrawing the circuit. Okay, this is terminal A and this is the 1 ohm resistance I am connecting over here. Another terminal of 1 ohm resistance is connected to 5 ohms. Okay, I am connecting over here. Another terminal of 5 ohm resistor is connected to 4 ohm resistance. So, I am connecting 4 ohms. Okay, terminal B. We have to find equivalent resistance between A and B terminal, right? So, A terminal, B terminal. As these three resistances are connected in series, equivalent resistance will be R1 plus R2 plus R3. So, 1 plus 5 plus 4. That is equivalent to 10 ohms. So, we have got equivalent resistance between A and B terminals as 10 ohms. So, RAB is equivalent to 10 ohms. Friends, equivalent resistance between A and B terminals is completed. Now I am going to do equivalent resistance between AY terminals. Okay, for that, taking out the confusion, I am taking voltage source between A and Y terminals. This is A terminal, this is Y terminal. So I am taking voltage source with A as more positive. Okay, this is 100 volts. I am taking the current friends. Current will always flow from positive to negative, right? So, current I. Okay, after this, through 1 ohm resistance. As this is an open circuit, take it out from the circuit. Okay, after 1 ohm, it is going to pass through the 5 ohm resistance. As this is an open circuit, you can take it out from the circuit. And here you can see path 1 and path 2. Okay, Here you can see open circuit, friends. Okay, just take it out from the circuit, this both. So it will flow like this, and current through 6 ohm, that will be, I am taking this as I1 and this as I2. I is divided into I1 and I2. Okay, I1 will be flowing through a short circuit path and through 6 ohm resistance, and here comes I1, and like this I2 will flow. Here it is I2. I1 and I2 will join up to form I. Will flow through 1 ohm resistance and form a closed path like this, and enter into a negative terminal of 100 volts voltage source. Friends, I am drawing the circuit diagram. Here you can see A terminal. So terminal A, 1 ohm resistance is connected in series with 5 ohm resistance. So here comes 1 ohm resistance. Here comes 5 ohm resistance. 5 ohm resistance, another terminal is connected to common terminal of 3 and 6 ohms. So I am connecting over here. And 3 ohm and 6 ohm are connected in parallel. So 3 ohm over here, 6 ohm. Common terminal of 3 ohm and 6 ohm is connected to 1 ohm resistance. So here come 1 ohm. Another terminal of 1 ohm is Y. So Y. Okay. We have got equivalent resistance of 3 ohms and 6 ohm connected in parallel is 2 ohms. Okay, I am doing it once again. 3 into 6 by 3 plus 6. 3 into 6 equal to 18. 3 plus 6 equal to 9. Equivalent to 2 ohms. Redrawing the circuit. This is terminal A. 1 ohm. 5 ohm. And here comes 2 ohm, which is equivalent resistance of 3 ohms and 6 ohms connected in parallel. And this is 1 ohm. Here you can see terminal Y. Equivalent resistance will be R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus R4. 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 2, 4, 4 plus 5, 9. Okay, R equivalent is equal to, that is RAY is equivalent to 9 ohms. Therefore, we got RAY is equivalent to 9 ohms. Friends, coming to the equivalent resistance between B and Y terminals. Here you can see Y terminal, here you can see the B terminal. So, to avoid confusion, I am taking the voltage source over here. I am taking voltage source of value 1 volt. Okay. I am drawing the current. Current always flows from positive to negative, right? Here is the positive terminal, so I am taking current in the upward direction. Okay, current will be flowing through 4 ohm resistance. Here you can see 3 paths, path 1, path 2 and path 3. This is the open circuit, right? So I am taking it from the circuit. This is path 2. So current will be flowing through this. I am taking this as I1 and I am taking this as I2. I2 will be flowing like this, and here I2 have 3 paths, path 1, path 2 and path 3. As this is the open circuit, you can take this out from the circuit. This is also open circuit. So I2 will be flowing through 3 ohm resistance. So I2 will be flowing here. Over here I1 plus I2 will add. So it forms a I, current I, flowing through 1 ohm resistance, coming like this and end up at the negative terminal. Current I. Now I am drawing the equivalent circuit diagram over here, friends. This is terminal B. Terminal B and 4 ohm resistance. 4 ohm resistance, another terminal is connected to common terminal of 3 and 6 ohms. So this is 3 ohms and this is 6 ohms. common terminal of 3 and 6 ohms is connected to 1 ohm over here. Here comes the 1 ohm in Y terminal. Okay. We know equivalent resistance of 3 ohms and 6 ohms connected in parallel is equivalent to 2 ohms. Okay. Now I am redrawing the circuit. 4 ohms in series with 2 ohms in series with 1 ohm. Terminal B and terminal Y. Equivalent resistance will be equivalent to 4 ohms plus 2 ohms plus 1 ohm. As 3 resistances are connected in the series, R1 plus R2 plus R3. So equivalent resistance is 7 ohms. Equivalent resistance between B and Y is 7. Friends, coming to the equivalent resistance between B and U terminals. Here you can see B, and here you can see U terminal. Okay. Now, to avoid the confusion, I am taking the voltage source. I am taking B as more positive, friends. I am taking 10 volts right now. I am taking current I, and it will be flowing through 4 ohm resistance. After this, here we have 3 paths: path 1, path 2, and path 3. Okay, so here you can see this is the open circuit. So just take it out from the circuit. This is path 1 and this is path 2 right now. Okay. As this is a short circuit path, you can take this out from the circuit. Current always chooses low resistance path. So, I current will be flowing through this short circuit path. Okay, after coming to this, here we have two paths, path 1 and path 2. As this is the open circuit, take out from the circuit. Okay, so current will be flowing through 5 ohm resistance and then 2 ohm resistance and then to the negative terminal. I. Okay, so I am drawing the circuit again, friends. B terminal, 4 ohm resistance. 4 ohm resistance, another terminal is connected to 5 ohm resistance over here. And here you can see 5 ohm resistance and 2 ohm resistance is connected in series. Okay, 2 ohm resistance, another terminal is U. We have to find the equivalent resistance between B and U, right? So here we have got B and U. Okay, equivalent resistance when 3 resistances are connected in series is equivalent to R1 plus R2 plus R3, right? So 4 plus 2 plus 5. 5 plus 2 equal to 7. 7 plus 4 equal to 11. So equivalent resistance will be 11 ohms between B and U terminal. So equivalent to 11 ohms. Friends, coming to the equivalent resistance between B and X terminals. Here you can see X terminal, here you can see B terminal. Okay, I am finding the equivalent resistance. To avoid confusion, I am taking voltage source over here. B as more positive, I am taking 5 volts. And from X, current will be flowing through 4 ohm resistance, and at this point you have 3 paths, path 1, path 2 and path 3. This is the open circuit, right? I am taking it out from the circuit. Okay, here you can see current through 6 ohm resistance, and here is the open circuit. I am taking it out from the circuit. Okay, friends, as this is a short circuit path, current will be flowing through this path. Okay, neglect this path. So I am taking it out from the circuit. Okay, current I will be flowing through this short circuit path I. Over here I. Here you can see path 1 and path 2. Okay, as this is the open circuit, current will not be flowing through this path. Okay, current should be flowing through like this at X and coming to the negative terminal in this direction. Okay, I am drawing the equivalent circuit diagram over here. Okay, terminal B. forearm resistance. Forearm resistance, another tunnel is directly connected to X. This is equivalent resistance between B and X. We have got 4 ohms. Therefore, RBX will be equivalent to 4 ohms. Friends, please check these answers with your answers. If you have any feedback, please let me know, friends, so that it will boost my energy levels and make more interesting videos for you. If you have any doubts regarding this problem, you can use the comment box or you can use the group link in the description. Friends, if you like the video, please do like, share and comment for the video and subscribe to our channel and click on bell icon for more updates. Thanks for watching the video, friends.